Now we want to talk about Helicobacter pylori. Helicobacter pylori is a gram negative rod, full rod. It belongs to the Euryaceae family. Helicobacter pylori causes gastroenteritis, more than gastroenteritis and diarrhea, yes, but also the sequel that could be lymphoma, gastric lymphoma, MALT, this is mucus associated lymphatic tissue cancer about of the MALT, of this lymphatic tissue, and the change of environment because of all the inflammation can lead to intestinal, sometimes intestinal metaplasia of the stomach, because Helicobacter pylori is the only enzyme that, only bacteria that can survive to the acid of the stomach. So it survives and stays in the stomach and can produce the ulcers. Ulcers, usually gastric and duodenal ulcers. The gastric ulcers are in the antrum, and the duodenal ulcers are in the proximal duodenum, so it's distal gastric ulcer or proximal duodenal ulcer. The most common cause of ulcers, either gastric or duodenal, are because of Helicobacter pylori. But if we have an ulcer that is in the duodenum, we are almost certain that it's because of Helicobacter pylori, unless the ulcer is farther from the wall of the duodenum, in which case maybe could be Solinger-Ellison syndrome, but that we will see it in endocrinology. Alright, so H. pylori produces ulcers, and the sequel of ulcers is because of that inflammation. We can have a lymphoma, maltoma, or intestinal metaplasia of the gastric epithelium, and so adenocarcinoma, adenocarcinoma of the stomach. The virulence factor are urease, because the urease takes the acid content and converts it, well, takes the urease and converts it into ammonia, and so the ammonia neutralizes the acid, and so the Helicobacter pylori can survive to the acidic environment. This is an extremely virulence factor. Also, we have type 3, secretion system, that is the toxin binds to the bacteria, and then, the toxin from the bacteria binds to the cell, like this, and then can go through it, insert it, and then the recipient. Also, it is oxidase positive and catalase positive, so it's triple positive, and the therapy is also triple therapy. Usually, is amoxicillin plus clarithromycin plus proton pump inhibitor, omeprazole. If the patient is allergic to penicillin, instead of amoxicillin, we would give metronidazole. And we would add sometimes the quadruple therapy, that is bismuth in order to the ulcer heal, bismuth sulfacylate. And we can add sometimes tetracycline or other macrolides if we think that this strain is resistant to clarithromycin, to macrolides. So we have many therapies. The most common is the omeprazole, amoxicillin, and clarithromycin. If amoxicillin cannot give because of allergy, we switch to metronidazole. But we have others like the OAC, that is omeprazole, amoxicillin, clarithromycin. This is the classic. Next is the LAC, lantoprazole, amoxicillin, and clarithromycin. Then BMT, bismuth sulfacylate, metronidazole, and tetrasaki. And we can order is this the same plus plus amoxicillin. So this is kind of all the therapies that we can have for Helicobacter pylori. Also we can culture Helicobacter pylori. It is a little bit difficult to culture. It is a macrophage bacteria that grows in 37 degrees Celsius, and the stain is Jamieson.